Hey guys, Cobra here. Well, it's Saturday afternoon down here in New Zealand and winter time, so it's a bit cold. And I was just in my room and I saw I had a little pile of cars on the floor that I have been meaning to open for a while. So I thought I may as well pull the camera out and we'll do a quick video. I'm basically going to crack open the three cars that you can see that are still carded at the back there. But I wanted to just take the opportunity to quickly show you the cars that are in my Majorette loose collection at the moment. Obviously Falcon and Eagle have some of these as well, so we've probably got about the same number of cars each from Majorette. So these were mostly sent to us by Majorette themselves, so thanks very much for sending us those, and we're hoping potentially we might get some more of these to review on our channel. But we'll just quickly show you through the cars that we've got. So that's a very beautiful blue metal chrome. I've got a couple of the newer Subaru WRX STIs, and the cool thing about the Majorette models is they have these clear headlight lenses typically, and this one has opening features. It has opening doors, as you can see. But you can go back and watch some of our previous Majorette videos if you want to see more about these cars individually. I noticed that there's another, I think there's probably about three or four versions of this, color variations of this Subaru that are out at the moment that I still need to acquire for my collection. Beautifully done Viper SRT. Just love the paint on that. This classic Renault. And there's a version of this that's in rally decals as well. Beautiful, I think it's a Renault Alpine from memory. And then I'll go to these two. These are still in bags because I just want to keep them protected. But these are a couple of older Subaru WRXs. And this is the blob-eye headlight configuration. And this is in the World Rally Team color graphics. And they're a little bit harder to find. Can track them down mostly online from sellers from Asia, Hong Kong, and that sort of thing. Very cool looking decals. Got a couple of Audis here. I am an Audi fan. The A1 is probably not my favourite Audi, but it looks really sporty in this sort of racing rally style graphics. So I've kept that one, and there's a stock blue version that you probably see on the street. The cool thing about these Majorettes is that some of them come with opening features like this, with opening doors, and the headlights are normally clear plastic inserts, and also you typically get suspension, so it's a little bit of bounce in that suspension. So that's one feature, or three features, of Majorette cars that make them appealing. Now this one is pretty legendary. This is highly desirable, very hard to find. I was fortunate enough to find one or two of these. So all three of us have this model, in addition to the one that we got sent by Majorette, of course. So that's probably one of the jewels of my Majorette collection. Then you've just got this basic Toyota Corolla sedan. May not be called Corolla in all territories, but it's just a basic sort of like a taxi almost model. But I really like it. It sort of reflects the current cars that you see on the roads. Now, I love Majorette rally cars. They do a superb job. Like, look at all the graphics. You've got graphics on the sides, the front, the roof. You've got rear decals as well. So just the amount of details that go into it. Plus, as I said before, you get those headlight lenses that come through from the interior. So fantastic, and that's in black. And then there's another white Ford Fiesta rally car here. In white with the Castrol Edge decals on it there. So it just looks stunning. It looks like a, just like a real WRC style rally car. So those are all the cars that I have in my loose collection. But if we have a look at these three, this is the newest car that I've seen from Majorette on the pegs. And so this is an Audi S5. So we're going to crack this open shortly. I'll just give you a look at it in the packaging. And this is from the premium cars line, which offers suspension, moving parts or opening features, and of course the plastic headlight inserts. And there's the rear of the card. Now, I'm not sure how Majorette number all of these cars, but I think that there's a part of that above the barcode there. I think one of those numbers might be sort of referring to the actual casting. Okay, so we'll put this aside just for now while we look at the other two in the packet, and then I'll crack them open. So then we've got this Citroen DS3 WRC 2015 rally car, and the driver Sebastian Loeb. So that's what that Loeb means. So this is quite a well-known rally car. Sebastian Loeb, a very famous WRC driver. And before I turn it over, this is from the racing car series. And the racing car series is the most appealing of all the Majorette series to me, because I love to see the cars in their rally and racing decals. Don't get me wrong, I do love stock cars as well, but the rally cars especially appealing to me personally. And you can see it's actually got that gold metallic graphics on there too. And lastly, this is a VW Polo R WRC. So there's the image there. And this is basically the same car as this Red Bull Polo, but just in a different graphics scheme. And obviously the wheels on this one are chrome, as opposed to the all blacked out wheels on the Red Bull version. Sorry, I'm jumping around a little bit. This is not my usual filming style. But you can see there also I paid $7.99. So normal Hot Wheels cars in New Zealand are about $3. So you're paying about almost three times the price for these cars. But if you're buying them just the ones you really like, then I think it represents really great value. Okay, I'm just going to put the camera down, and we'll try and do this consistently, but if the camera's not quite right, I might just have to move it around. Let me actually clear all of these off and make some room. Alright, so just might as well keep him in shot, because we'll compare him to the Volkswagen Polo RWRC here. So I'm going to open this with a knife, so kids, if you're watching, just make sure you've got a parent or guardian supervising when you're opening these. Now, I wasn't really thinking too much when I was coming through to film this, so I haven't done a lot of planning on this. But I just realized that with the Majorette cars, you typically can't really open them that easily with a knife, because the plastic that the car is within actually goes all the way up the card, and covers over this special collector card here too. So although I don't want to ruin the card, you do actually end up having to tear open the card like so, making a bit of a mess. That's live take for you. So you get this little collector card, which is a nice little addition to have in the collection. Get some stats there on the vehicle, so you can pause that if you want to read those. And here's the car itself up close. So really nice wheels on this. Some of the nicer wheels. Wheels have always been a little bit of an issue for Majorette, but in the last sort of 2 to 3 years, they've really improved the wheel designs on these. So you can see there's quite a lot of sponsor graphics on these cars, including the big VW badge on the roof there. Let's compare it to the Red Bull version. So side by side, they're definitely looking very similar. Obviously you've got some extra details on the Red Bull one with like the Polo logo across the radiator. Trying to get the focus, so apologies if it's not focusing too quickly. I think that I prefer the Red Bull one, just the black wheels. That looks really awesome. I mean, honestly, this is one of the best castings I think I've seen from Majorette, this Red Bull Polo. But I do like the graphic design on this one as well. Let me know in the comments which one you like best out of these two. So we've got the regular VW Type R and you've got the Red Bull Type R. Okay, so we'll put those two aside. And open the other rally one, which is the Citroen DS3 WRC 2015 Sebastian Loeb edition. Now I'm just going to tear this one open because, as I say, you can't really easily open the card back to get the card out on these. So I've got the car and the card now. So there's the card. So a nice white, gold and red colour. And I've probably said it before, I'll just pause, you can pause the video there if you want to read the details on that card. But I've said it before, I absolutely love metallic graphics on the cars. For some reason it just looks incredible when they have the gold or the silver or even some of the sort of blues and that sort of thing that are metallic on the vehicles. So this is, they've gone all out on these graphics, check all that out. Absolutely stunning. It's even got the WRC 2015 logo on there. So these are licensed cars, I should also mention. Majorette, you know, doesn't do a whole lot of fantasy cars. They do make some fantasy cars, but these ones are just stunning. These are licensed vehicles. That's probably why you do pay a little bit more for these. Right, and the last one that we've got to open today is this Audi S5. So as I already mentioned, I'm a fan of Audi. I love Audi vehicles. I sort of see them as almost like a premium Subaru, if you like, with their four-wheel drive systems and the performance that you get out of them. So definitely, if I could afford one, I would probably drive an Audi out of all the European cars available. Just getting that collector card out. There we go. Let's have a look at those stats. You can pause that again there if you want to read those. And let's have a look at the car. Now this car is actually inside a little clamshell that came within the blister, so it just keeps it additionally protected. And probably just to help hold this door open, just to show the opening features. So I'd say that door line is a little bit, there's a little bit of gap in that door line there. Could possibly be a little bit narrower, but obviously you've got to have enough tolerance for it to move. So it's quite acceptable. You can see the interior in there. So this is a left-hand drive. So obviously European and US markets. Got an interesting way of doing the front grille there, which is more like a tampo onto the metal surface. But that's what Hot Wheels chose to do as well for their Audis. Rather than having a plastic grille or a sort of molded metal cast grille on the front there, cast into the metal. You've got the wing mirrors as well. It's nice to see. Sometimes those get left off for cost reasons or technical reasons. And you've got the Audi badge on the rear. Now, you can't tell, oh, well, I can't tell if those rear taillights are coloured or not. I don't think they are, because the vehicle itself is red. It's hard to tell whether those are got anything on them, but I would expect if they were tampoed, you'd probably see the some other colour light, like the marker lights or the reverse lights. It's a little bit hard to see, but there is actually an S5 badge just to the left of where the license plate would go. The wheels on this are okay, probably not as realistic as perhaps I would like. I'd like to see something a bit more sporty, a bit more aggressive on this, because this will be a performance car. So a two-door sort of coupe. That's a nice addition to the collection, and I do believe this has come out in a range of other colours. Let's just have a look. There's the suspension in action. And you can generally tell the Majorette cars that have suspension generally have these two rectangles on the base. Alright, well, I hope you've enjoyed watching this cracking video. It was a little bit impromptu just because I saw I had had these cars sitting on the floor, and I thought probably time to open them up and add them to the loose collection. But I hope you enjoyed watching, and I'll see you in the next video.